Morning, ladies and gentlemen. I welcome you to this session of ISO 9001:2015. Today we are going to talk about leadership and commitment, that is clause number 5.1. Now, in the leadership, the topmost requirement is that the management has to take accountability for effectiveness of the system. They have to ensure that the system is built based on the requirements, and then it is made available and effectively run. So the effectiveness of the system is the responsibility of the top management. The system has to be integrated with the business processes, and we have to promote the use of process approach, ensuring that the resources needed for the quality management system are also available, and engaging, directing and supporting the personnel to effectively carry out the implementation of the system, and supporting other relevant management roles to demonstrate so that they can demonstrate their responsibility in their area of work. Now, the second point, 5.1.2, in this clause, it talks about the customer focus. Now, customer focus is very important, and the top management has to ensure that they talk about customer focus, and the realization that customer focus has to be maintained by all concerned within the organization. So that has to be ensured by the top management. The risk and opportunities can affect conformity of the output, and therefore that has to be taken care to meet the customer requirements. And the focus on enhancing the customer satisfaction, that has to be maintained. Now the clause, next clause 5.2, talks about the quality policy. Now the quality policy has to be established by the organization. The policy has to be appropriate to the purpose and the context of the organization, and it has to provide a framework for setting the quality objectives. That means within the quality objectives, we have to mention about the objectives that we are going to comply with. And then includes a commitment. The policy must have a commitment to satisfy the applicable requirements of the standard, and also commitment for continual improvement of the system. Now, once the quality policy has been established and is ready to be given to the people within the organization, then the next thing is that it has to be communicated to everybody. It must be displayed in all major areas, for example, in the offices of all the HODs, in the assembly area, in the conference rooms, at reception, and wherever it is found necessary, so that the policy is communicated to all those working within the organization. It has to be available and is to be maintained as a documented information. That means the record of quality policy has to be maintained, including the date of issue, the version of this policy. It has to be maintained. And as we discussed, it has to be communicated, understood, and applied within the organization, and available to the relevant parties as appropriate. If you think that it is necessary to provide it to your customers and that's going to help you, you can by all means provide it to the customer. In the earlier version of ISO 9001:2008, that was not the requirement. The policy was to be circulated within the organization. It was not necessary to pass on to the external agencies. Now, in this standard, perhaps my interpretation is that you can share it with the interested parties where you feel necessary. Now, next clause after the policy is the organizational roles and responsibilities and authorities of the personnel working within the organization. And the top management has to ensure that the responsibility and authorities are established and communicated within the organization, ensuring that the quality management system conforms to the international standard, ensuring that the processes are delivering the intended results, reporting on the performance of the quality management system to the top management, ensuring the promotion of customer focus, and ensuring that the integrity of the quality management system is maintained. That means you have to ensure that only controlled documents are used by the people, so that the latest version of every document, whether it is a procedure or the policy or some work instruction or any other document or the quality plan, any other document, they have to be of the latest version. So this was all within this particular clause, and the next clause pertains to planning, which we shall discuss in the next session of ISO. So please keep in touch, subscribe the videos which you are watching so that you can keep in touch and the latest video information will reach you. So till you get the next video, goodbye, and thank you all for watching this video.